Hey friends, HashiCorp Terraform is an open source infrastructure as code tool for provisioning any infrastructure anywhere. So it's no surprise, of course, that you can provision a Kubernetes cluster on AKS using Terraform. Mishra from HashiCorp is here to show me how it works on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Mishra, and you don't work for Microsoft.
No, I don't. I work for HashiCorp.
Fantastic. I like having people from all over because it's open source software making great clouds work. HashiCorp has a bunch of different products.
Yeah, we make six different open source products in different spaces like security, provisioning space, runtime space. So we make open source software. They're pretty popular. Today we'll talk about Terraform though, kind of focus on Terraform.
Right, so on the deployment side, Terraform works with AKS?
Yeah, it works with AKS. So Microsoft and HashiCorp have a really good partnership. So we have an Azure provider that enables us to provision pretty much anything in Azure in terms of Azure Resource Manager. And then AKS is one of those resources.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's people who already know how to use Terraform will then feel very comfortable and feel like they understand what's going on.
Yeah, exactly. So the idea is that folks that are already using Terraform or they want to use Terraform, they can just pick it up. It's pretty simple, pretty easy to kind of pick up. On the other side, we also have support for Terraform in the Azure shell as well. So there's a Terraform binary that's dropped in. So as soon as you open your Azure shell, you should have that available.
Wow, that's a really interesting thing. So that means if I go to shell.azure.com and I type TF, I've got Terraform right there without having to do anything.
No. Yeah, everything is configured for you, so you're good to go. So you can get started.
That's pretty cool. So people right now who may be watching this may not be familiar with Terraform. They already have this. They can just learn how to use it, and they've already got it configured in their shell.
Yeah.
So you brought me some demos.
Yeah, so today we're going to kind of focus into provisioning a Kubernetes cluster using using Terraform and using like the Azure provider for doing this. Mm-hmm. So here I'll just go through the configuration here. Here I have a simple Terraform configuration. The first thing we see here is the provider, which is the Azure RM provider, Azure Resource Manager. Mm-hmm. So we support all the APIs and every object that the API exposes on the Microsoft side. And then we start off with like creating a resource group. So mm-hmm. the idea is that all the compute resources in Azure, they need to correspond to a resource group. And in this case, we'll create a resource group using Terraform. So this is the resource group type of resource and the name of the resource. And then we focus in and on the core of the example here. This is the Kubernetes cluster resource. And that's pretty much all you need. So all you need is this, like these many lines of code mm-hmm. to create a Kubernetes cluster in Azure.
As a quick point of note, I'm noticing that you're on a Mac, you're in Visual Studio Code,
yes.
and you're in a .tf file, you've got IntelliSense. Have you added an extension for Terraform?
Yeah, so there is an etcl parser on the Visual Studio side in the plugins, I think you can just find it.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Makes it really easy to understand this.
Totally.
I'm assuming that these are different variables that you're pulling out to make this, like var.clustername is coming from somewhere.
Exactly. So I'm just going to walk through the configuration here.
Please.
So the first thing we see here is the cluster name. These are these things like names and locations, they're called attributes in Terraform.
Okay.
So the name has a variable called cluster name. Mm-hmm. And if you go to the variables file here, we have cluster name defined. And it's hard-coded for now, but you can also provide it using the CLI if you wanted to.
Okay.
In this case, I'm just going to hard-code it. And then things like the resource group name and the location is actually not defined in a variable. It's being referenced between the two resources. I'm referencing the Azure RM resource group and getting the name and the location. So in this type of syntax in Terraform is called interpolation. So you can interlink resources together. So now Terraform, when it goes ahead and creates these resources, it'll actually create the resource group first and then create the Kubernetes cluster because it knows it depends on it. And you don't have to explicitly provide that reference. This is automatically done using graph theory.
Oh, so let me see if I understand that for a second. If you wouldn't mind scrolling up a little bit,
yeah.
and maybe we can get a full wide shot of me pointing at this. So that's a declaration of something I want, and that's a declaration of something I want.
Totally.
Now, it's not necessarily a programmatically in order thing. It's like, I need one of these, and I need one of those, and this. This dot this dot this refers to this dot this dot that.
Yeah, that's absolutely
and
right.
And graph theory, as you said, then
it creates
a
dependency
who
graph.
Who goes first?
Exactly.
Very cool.
So it'll try to provision as many things in parallel as possible. Yeah. So this is it. And then you provide things like the admin username if you wanted to. You can actually generate a private and a public key using Terraform as well. That's what I'm doing with the TLS resource. And then provide things like the agent count and things like that, and that's all defined here too. So we need like three agents in this case, and mm-hmm. I'm defining that here, and that's it. And then And then in terms of like the outputs, so Terraform also has this notion of outputs. So you can actually output things out of the resource using the output syntax right here. So what you can do is you can use interpolation again to pull out the output. In this case, we're pulling out the Kubernetes config. Mm-hmm. And this is what we'll use in the demo to kind of configure the client side. And then also pulling out the host name. And I'm just like outputting some simple commands that we can use to configure the client side.
So this chunk between configure and configure, this is a shell script?
This here I'm just like outputting some string.
So that's help.
That's help for us, yeah.
So you can
do things like this as well. So you'll see how this all comes together when I go through the demo.
I see. Thank you.
So now we'll move into the terminal and kind of, you know, the first thing when you go through the certain set of Terraform commands, the first thing you do is do a Terraform init, which initializes your environment. Mm-hmm. And this will download all the plugins that you need, all the modules that you might be using and things like that. Then the next command you run is a Terraform plan. Now this is unique to Terraform. So basically Terraform shows you what's going to happen before it actually happens. So in this case, Terraform is showing you that it's going to add four resources. And these are the four resources, as you can see, the Kubernetes cluster, the resource group, and in this case, some TLS keys.
So it's doing it, but not doing it. It's a simulation.
Yeah.
It's a what-if scenario.
Exactly. It's a dry run. This is completely safe to run. It's only a read-only operation. Doesn't do anything. But what you can do here is actually share this plan across your organization. So you can share this with operations team or a security team to get a plus one and being like, okay, this change makes sense. And you can make predictable changes, which is one of the goals of Terraform. Once this is done, you can actually go ahead and apply if you want to. In this case, we'll just run the apply,
okay, and
it'll go through the application process. This takes up to 10 minutes on the Azure side to create, so I've already pre-created a cluster for us, and we'll kind of use that. And this is all kicked off, and maybe we'll see it at the end created. But yeah, we'll move to the same project. I've just changed the name. I've pre-provisioned the resources.
Right. Now, it's just like when you put the pie in the cake and then the stove, and then you put the perfect
the
pie.
The cooking shows. Yeah, that's exactly right.
Fantastic.
So I'll run plan here. And then this plan should tell us that everything is, there's no changes, basically, because we've already provisioned everything.
So does that mean that it is important to point out that Terraform is re-entrant, in that I can run it multiple times without fear of destruction?
Totally.
I am making a declaration of what I want, and if I've already got that, it's like, yep, still cool.
Yeah.
We're good.
That's absolutely right. And Terraform also has this notion of state. And we won't go into state in depth, but the idea is that it tracks all the resources throughout the lifecycle. So from being created to being changed to being destroyed, it'll kind of track the resource across its lifecycle.
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, if you run apply here, we'll kind of get those outputs, the outputs that which we saw in the previous code examples. So here you see that's a lot of certificate text. So what you get out from the Kubernetes resource is this Kubernetes config file in raw format. You get the host name, and you also get some helper commands to do things. So let's start with the Terraform output command. This will only filter certain things that we need to kind of see to configure the client side. So we'll do we'll kind of output the configure variable, and this is the helper text that we saw, right? So now we'll kind of configure the client side so we can access the Kubernetes cluster that we created. So the first thing we'll do is dump that raw config Kubernetes config file /aks config. This is the standard Kubernetes.
Is this a normal way to do things? Is it not expected that Terraform doesn't do everything, but it structures everything?
Yeah.
But I could take the command that you just did, the plan, and these two or three, and then put it into a shell script.
Yeah,
that would be totally appropriate.
Yeah, that's totally right. It has local provisioners and also remote provisioners, and they can trigger based on a resource. So once a resource is changed, you can trigger the shell script again, and it'll dump out the things again if you wanted to.
Okay.
In this case, I wanted to kind of go through these steps so we can show the users how we can connect through
things. Yeah, I appreciate that.
We'll dump that in. And again, if I cat this file, this is that crazy Kubernetes configuration file. I'll output this again, and then we'll set this kubeconfig environment variable. This is what kubectl and all the client-side tools use to kind of get to the Kubernetes configuration file.
Excellent.
Once that's done, we'll do kubectl get nodes.
And that's going to do the get nodes using the kubeconfig that Terraform
that we just created
got out of AKS, and that is right now, boom, there it is.
Yeah, so now AKS we have live. A working cluster. It was provisioned like a day ago because I pre-provisioned things. But here, we are able to connect directly. Now I want to kind of take this a step further and kind of showcase some of the other features in Terraform. So we also have a Kubernetes provider. So if we go into the pod directory, sorry, I can barely type. Oh my God, okay. So you go to part service example. This is another Terraform configuration project. Here you see the provider instead of Azure, if you remember from the previous example.
Azure RM provider.
Now it's the Kubernetes provider. So we're going to invoke the Kubernetes provider and create a Kubernetes namespace, Kubernetes pod, and a service.
So does that allow me, with all due respect to our friends at Kubernetes, to hide from some of the difficult parts, the YAML and the things that I don't want to think about? So I'm comfortable with Terraform. I prefer Terraform. While the YAML and the things that kubectl provide and the JSON and the things that ARM provides on the Azure side, I can use one language and one tool to configure both of those things.
That's totally the goal with the Kubernetes provider, that we want operators that are using Terraform to provision multi-cloud clusters or Azure, VMs in Azure. They can use the same language. They've learned it. They understand it. They understand the steps of planning and applying. So they just use that across the board. So in this case, we'll just create that pod, and it's just a simple Nginx container, which will just give us an Nginx web page, and also kind of expose that as type load balancer.
Of course.
That'll give us an IP that we can kind of access on the outside world. And similarly, we'll go to this project, we'll do a Terraform init, which initializes the thing. It downloads the Kubernetes provider, and then we'll run a plan, which is very similar to the previous step. So in this, you'll notice I'm only adding one resource because I pre-provisioned the service and the namespace, because the service on the Azure side, the load balancer takes like at least 5 minutes to come up. So just for the time's sake, I'll pre-provision this. Now we'll go ahead and apply it. And then this will create that pod and just start the Nginx container on it. Mm-hmm. And now what we can do is kind of see the pod running. So if you do get pods, actually, I have this in my history. Bash history is your friend. Oh. If you know how to use it.
I'm still learning. It's been 25 years and I'm almost there.
So as you can see, the pod's running and our service is ready, and it has an external IP of that. And this is all running in Azure, and you can see, welcome to Nginx. This is the classic example that people love to show.
No, but it's a great example because to the point that I personally find ARM to be a little bit overwhelming, and I find the YAML and some of the requirements, I spend more time getting my YAML wrong than I do messing with, and being able to do this all in Terraform is a very comforting thing, and you saw how quickly we were able to put that together.
Totally, yeah, I think the partnership with Microsoft has been really pivotal for achieving these things like that. We are able to work on a preview. We were able to work on stages like preview. When AKS was in preview, we had support for it. Mm-hmm. As soon as it became GA, we released the support for it, and we are super excited too.
So in our remaining few seconds, where do people go to learn about this, how we can use Terraform on Azure?
Yeah, so you can go to terraform.io, and that's like our landing page. It has all our documentation. You can also go to the Terraform module registry. It has a bunch of pre-baked modules as well. Mm. There should be a module for AKS, for an AKS cluster if you wanted to. You can scroll through that.
And you can use Terraform for all kinds of Azure services.
Yeah, everything. Everything that the Azure Resource Manager supports, we kind of support it.
Fantastic. I am learning all about how to automate Azure, and in this case, Azure Kubernetes Service, using Terraform today on Azure Friday.